أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألم تر أن الفلك تجري في البحر بنعمة الله ليريكم من آياته، إن في ذلك لآيات لكل صبار شكور. وإذا غشيهم موج كالظلل دعوا الله مخلصين له الدين، فلما نجاهم إلى البر فمنهم مقتصد، وما يجحد بآياتنا إلا كل ختار كفور. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم واخشوا يوما لا يجزي والد عن ولده ولا مولود هو جاز عن والده شيئا، إن وعد الله حق، فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Respected elders and brothers, our beloved viewers at home, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, today we're sitting for the fourth time in an attempt to, inshallah, finish the discussion around Surah Luqman. And we are up to verse number 31. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ الْفُلْكَ تَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ بِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ لِيُرِيَكُمْ مِنْ آيَاتِهِ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ. So just a quick translation first, and then we'll talk about this verse a little bit. So Allah says, have you not seen the ships that sail through the sea by the favor of Allah, so that he may show you his signs? Indeed, in that there are signs for everyone who is patient and grateful. So the first things first in this verse is that miracles and signs of Allah's existence are all around us. We don't have to exert too much effort or energy to find that there's a divine and supreme being who's in control of all things. And one such thing is the ships that carry thousands and thousands of tons of weight. There are ships that are almost like airports that carry airplanes and armies and so much and so on and so forth. They're all floating right on the surface of the water. Yet when you throw a penny, it drowns. What's the mystery? What's the formula behind this? Who has allowed this to happen? Such a miraculous thing to happen. So Allah says, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ الْفُلْكَ تَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ. Don't you see these huge, humongous, heavy ships that are just traveling and sailing through the sea without them drowning? Where, how did that happen? Right, right now we might not realize the importance of this, but there's actually so many things that we need every single day that cannot be transported except through the sea. The food, the grocery, the furniture, the whatever else that you want to talk about, they are not shipped through the air, because some things just would cost too much, and the airplane can only carry that so much. And so the best route is through the ocean. And so right now, at any given moment, there's probably thousands of vessels and loads of shipments that are on the sea. All of that is happening because Allah has allowed it to happen. It's not some special feature that the water has, but Allah has allowed this for our convenience. So do you not see these ships that sail and float in the ocean by the ni'mah of Allah Azza wa Jal? Why? لِيُرِيَكُمْ مِنْ آيَاتِهِ. Just one of the many, many, many signs of Allah Azza wa Jal. You just have to open your eye and open your heart, and you will see it's there. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ. Indeed, in that there are signs for every person who is sabbah, who is always patient, and shakur, who is always grateful and ponders over these things. It's not like I just go to the grocery and pick up my stuff, rather think about where all this stuff comes from and how these things are shipped and transported. The mango that you see on the table, you know, you open it up and you might complain about, oh, it's not sour enough, it's not sweet enough or whatever. But if you give it a thought for a minute, how long it took for this mango to arrive at your table, just think about it. And that will make you grateful to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And at times when things are not good, you are patient about it. Now, since we're talking about the sea, is magnanimous. It's so powerful, the water. It can take away towns and countries. So one incident that happened regarding this verse is that Ikramah ibn Abu Jahl, the son of Abu Jahl, he actually ran away. He fled from the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam when Makkah was conquered. So he was trying to run away because he's like, you know what? My father did all this to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and here I am. I'm the son of him, and I've done so much too. So there's no way for me to stay here with dignity. I should just run away. So he rode over the Red Sea to cross over to Ethiopia. But as he proceeded with whoever else was going with him, a heavy storm with all the wind with it overtook their boat, and the boat capsized, and huge waves came to them from all different sides, and they thought that they were going to die. They were completely encircled. So the people of the boat said to one another that no one can save you right now except Allah, the true God of the heavens and the earth. So all of you call to Allah, making your faith, your invocation, your calling, your dua only to Him, so that He can deliver you to safety and not drown here on this day. So Ikramah, the son of Abu Jahl, he said to himself that by Allah, if none can benefit in the sea except Allah alone, then no doubt none can benefit over the land except Allah alone. So then he says, oh Allah, I promise you that if you deliver me safe from this, I will go and put my hands in the hand of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and surely I will find him full of pity, kindness, and mercy. So they were delivered safe by Allah and were returned to the seashore, and they came out of the sea. Ikramah then proceeded to Allah's messenger, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and he narrated this story and he embraced Islam. And so Ikramah became actually a great companion of Sahabi of the Prophet. And this is mentioned in this Tafsir Ibn Kathir. So this is just one example of people seeking Allah's help when they realize that all this stuff that they believed in before, it was all out of ego and pride. But in reality, truly, there's only one true supreme being. And this scenario might not happen to all of us, but scenarios similar to this can happen to us. Like if we're really, really sick in the hospital, someone who we love is in a coma, or they're in the brinks of death and they're passing out and they're coming back. And in moments like that, we turn to Allah, even those people who never believe in Allah, right? So Allah says, وَإِذَا غَشِيَهُمْ مَوْجٌ, and when waves come over them, كَالظُلَلْ, like shadows and canopies and mountains, so big the waves are, they come over them, دَعَوُ اللَّهُ, what do? دَعَوُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ, they call to Allah Azza wa Jal, making their calling so sincere for him, completely all for Allah. So, but then when Allah Azza wa Jalla rescues them, فَلَمَّا نَجَّاهُمْ مِنَ الْبَرِّ, when Allah takes them to a safe shore, فَمِنْهُمْ مُخْتَصِدْ, some of those people who were desperate, they end up becoming moderate in their faith. Meaning like the case of Ikramah ibn Abu Jahl, he actually lived up to his word. And because there are many who won't live up to their word, they will just go back and live that life once again and be ungrateful. But he was actually moderate and he lived up to his word and he went to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and he accepted Islam. وَمَا أَجْحَدُ بِآيَاتِنَا إِلَّا كُلُّ خَتَّانٍ كَفُورٍ, and no one rejects our signs except those people who are khattar, treacherous, and kafur, ungrateful. So this is, again, these type of verses have passed several times, and the most we can say is that these verses should remind all of us about the power of Allah Azza wa Jal, and we might become numb to the things that are happening to us on a daily basis. Right? So we need to kind of remind ourselves about these things, especially about death itself. Right? Sometimes we think about death just happening to other people, a small minority is going to die, or like just some people end up dying. But that's not the case. Everybody will end up dying, and everybody, you will find yourself in that situation where you will find yourself to be so helpless and you have no control over yourself. And you know that there's nothing you can do to keep yourself in this world. A very famous CEO, very rich person. He was the founder of one of the biggest tech companies in the world right now. He died fairly at a younger age, and he had cancer. And so reportedly when he was asked that, what do you regret most, or what do you wish the most right now? He said, I have all the money in the world, but none of this money can bring me my health back. Meaning, what does that mean? That you have no control over yourself. The sooner we realize that we don't have control over ourselves, the sooner we will try to fix and amend our circumstances, our situations, and our affair and our relationship with Allah Azza wa Jalla. Temporarily, we're given power and control over our lives, but that is for a greater reason, a bigger responsibility that we have. So, talking about the hereafter, Allah says, "Ya ayyuhan nasu taqoo rabbakum wakhshaw yawman la yajzi walidun 'an waladi." That this small thing that might happen in this world, you're drowning in a ship, you're in a hospital, you're about to die, these things are nothing compared to the hereafter. So fear that day, O mankind, ittaqoo rabbakum, fear your Lord. Wakhshaw yawman la yajzi walidun 'an waladi, and fear that day where a father will not be able to benefit from his son, and his son will not be able to benefit from his father whatsoever at all. In other verses, Allah talks about the disbelievers who brag about their kids. My son did this, my daughter did this, and أحسن أثاثا ورئيا, and they talk about, brag about their families and stuff like that. You know, you hear about parents doing everything they can to make their children go to universities and institutions and schools that are elite so that they can have bragging rights. You know, children and parents, of course, benefit from one another. And that is one of the greatest joys for people to have children and see them flourish in this world. So Allah says, in this world, you depend on one another so much, but even the father and the son and the father won't be able to benefit from each other at all. Shay'an, nothing. They'll rather run away from one another. Inna wa'adallahi haqq. Indeed, the promise of Allah is truth. All the promise that Allah made, whether the promise that you are going to die, the promise that your family is not going to help one another, the promise of the day of judgment being true, and the world, the earth will be changed. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ. Allah says the world will change, everything will die, even the angels, they will die. And there was only one who remained. لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمَ لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. Only Allah, the one who will remain. All of these things are true. إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقْ. فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. So this temporary worldly life, don't let that deceive you. Don't let that delude you. We are so absorbed and immersed and involved and engaged with this temporary world. Everything becomes about this world, our job, our money, our career, our children. And then at the age of wherever it might be, we start realizing that I am getting old. Even now, in the age of 20 and 30 and 40, you start realizing you're changing and you have no control over that. No control over how you're going to look in 5 years, the energy you're going to lose in 5 years. No matter how much you exercise, how much you eat healthy, and how much money you spend on your healthcare, you cannot ever be here forever. So don't let this world deceive you. And do not let the deceiver, who is shaitan, deceive you from Allah Azza wa Jal. Inna Allaha indahu ilmu sa'ah. Indeed, Allah alone has the knowledge of the hour of the day of judgment, when that will come. And no one knows anything about the day of judgment, when it will come. And Surah Taha, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, أَكَانُ أُخْفِيهَا, that I was about to hide it from myself. Allah says, I was about to hide it from myself. And the Arab used to say this because to show that how seriously they took this, they won't tell this anyone. this is such a big secret that I almost hid it from myself. I won't tell anyone. It's like how we say that this is going to the grave with me. That's how secretive this thing is. So to Allah belongs the day of judgment, the knowledge of the day of judgment. And many scholars have, you know, explored the alternatives of if we knew when the day of judgment would be, you know, we would start relaxing. We'd know when the day of judgment would be. We won't take it seriously. Or if you knew when we were going to die, you know, we would just, for 99% of our life, we would just do whatever you want. You know, there would be chaos in this world if we knew when we were going to die. وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثِ وَيَلْعَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, He's the one that brings down the rain, which is actually the reason why we're alive, which is how we get our food and nutrition and plants and etc. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ. And Allah knows what is in the wombs of the mothers and what good and bad lives they will lead once they're delivered into this world. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا. And a soul does not know what it will earn tomorrow. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتٍ. And a soul does not know in which land it will die. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. Indeed, Allah is Alim, all-knowing, Khabir, all-aware, all-acquainted of all that you do. So this is the end of Surah Luqman, Surah Al-Isha, inshallah, is going to start soon. So we will wrap it up here for today. And if Allah Azza wa Jalla gives us Hayatan Tayyiba, we will sit again next week and continue our short discussions that we have every Sunday. Allah Azza wa Jalla give us all the tawfiq to understand, to implement, and bring into practice the message and meanings that Allah Azza wa Jalla conveyed for us in the Quran. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. السلام عليكم.